to Through the Bible. Let us continue with the stories from the book of Judges. Gideon becomes Israel's judge. Judges chapter 6. It seems as if the Israelites would never learn that disobedience of God's commandments always caused them trouble and sorrow. When the 40 years of peace ended, they were once again misbehaving themselves and God had to again punish them. This time, they had to suffer the attacks of the Midianites for 7 long years. The Midianites were desert dwellers coming in from east of the Jordan. Every year, when the Israelites' crops were ready for reaping, they swept in and stole everything. Even the grazing lands were stripped of grass and bushes by the camels, sheep, and cattle the Midianites drove in. There were so many of the Midianites that they seemed to the Israelites to be like grasshoppers, and the Israelites had to hide away in caves or amongst the rocks on the mountain tops. To grow any food at all, they had to make use of little patches of land away between the rocks where they could not be seen by the enemy bands. Any grain they managed to reap, they had to hide away in caves or in cracks in the rocks. God made it clear to the Israelites why these things were happening to them. He sent a prophet to them to remind them of all He had done for their people in bringing them out of Egypt and into the land of Canaan. He reminded them, too, of the warning He had given them not to worship the false gods of the heathen nations in Canaan, but they had not obeyed. That was why they were suffering now. One day, one of the Israelites, Gideon, the son of Joash, was threshing wheat at a place called Ophrah in a hole in a rock, which was normally used as a wine press. Suddenly, sitting under an oak tree next to where he worked, there was an angel from God. The angel spoke to him, "The Lord is with you, you brave man." But Gideon replied, "Oh my Lord, if the Lord is with us, why has all this happened to us? Where are the miracles the Lord once did to help our fathers when He brought them out of Egypt? But now the Lord God has turned away from us and let us fall into the hands of the Midianites." But in mercy, the Lord answered, "Do not be afraid. Go out in strength to help your people, and you will save them from the Midianites. Do not think you are alone in the fight. I shall be with you." But Gideon was still afraid. He was a poor man of a poor family belonging to one of the least important of the tribes, Manasseh. "Please, Lord," he said, "if thou art really with me, give me a sign to show it. I feel so weak. But wait a while, please, till I have made ready a gift for thee." Then Gideon went and prepared some cakes of unleavened bread and some goat's meat with a pot of broth. He took this food out to where the angel was still waiting under the oak tree. But the angel did a strange thing. He told Gideon to lay the meat and the cakes of bread on the rock in front of him and to put out the broth over the meat and the bread. When Gideon had done that, the angel reached out and touched with his staff the food on the rock. At once fire burst out of the rock and the offering of food was burnt up. And as this happened, the angel disappeared from sight. How horrified Gideon was to see what happened. He hadn't really understood that the stranger who had come to him was an angel from God. And he was terrified because in those days, people believed very firmly that if anyone saw one of the heavenly beings face to face, he would die. Terrified, Gideon cried out to God, "What shall I do? Because I have seen an angel face to face." But God knew how he felt and comforted him. "Let peace be in your heart. Do not be afraid. You will not die." Gideon was so glad to receive that comforting message of peace that at once he got busy building an altar to make an offering of thanksgiving to God. He gave the place a special name too. He called it Jehovah Shalom, the Lord is peace. For many years, the altar stood there and people pointed it out as the place where God had made his wonderful promise to Gideon and the defeat of the Midianites had begun. The very same night, the Lord told Gideon that he had to do. His first task was not to fight against the Midianites, but to free his own people from their pagan worship, which made God so angry with them. So with 10 men, Gideon went out and cut down the little wood where false worship was paid to Ashtaroth and broke down the altar to Baal. On the same spot, he set up an altar to God, and using the wood from the trees they had chopped down, he offered up a young bullock as a burnt offering to God. When morning came and the people of the little town awoke, they were shocked to see what had happened. They did not know who had done it, but quickly one of them guessed it must have been Gideon. They rushed off to his father Joash and told him they wanted to kill Gideon for what he had done. But Joash was not afraid. "If Baal is really a god," he said, "he is able to take care of himself. He will himself punish the person who broke down his altar." When the people saw that Gideon was not harmed, they began to turn back to the true God. Soon afterward, the armies of Midian, Amalek, and the people of the east formed an alliance against Israel and crossed the Jordan, camping in the valley of Jezreel. The Spirit of the Lord took possession of Gideon. He blew a ram's horn as a call to arms, and the men of the clan of Abiezer came to him. After this, Gideon sent out messengers to the people of Manasseh, Asher, Zebulun, and Naphtali, asking their men to come and meet him. The gathering place was around the fountain at Herod, on the slopes of Mount Gilboa. In the meantime, Gideon turned again to God. He believed in God and he wanted to be certain that it was really God's will for him to lead his people against the Midianites. He had doubts about taking on the mighty army in the valley. He prayed and said, "If it is thy plan to use me to save Israel, then give me a sign. I shall put a piece of woolly sheepskin on the floor. If in the morning there is dew on the fleece only and not on the ground round about, then I shall know it is right for me to lead the people." In the morning, that was exactly what happened, and Gideon was able to wring a whole bowl of water out of the fleece. But it seems he was still nervous, so he asked for another sign. This time, the fleece only must be dry and all the ground around wet. In the morning, God had again proved he would help Gideon to save his people. Gideon knew the Lord had chosen him and his small army to deliver the Israelites from 135,000 enemy soldiers encamped in the valley of Jezreel.